Richardson, and I'm a staff scientist here in the Body Zone at Science Farm. So mutations in your DNA, as we saw, can have a really, really important effect on your health and the way that you look. But where do these mutations come from? So as I said before, some mutations, like the mutation that causes sickle cell anemia, are inherited from your parents. So they're in your DNA when you're born. But other mutations can actually happen over the course of your lifetime, in the DNA in any one of your cells, anywhere in your body. And sometimes they can have important effects, for example, on your health. So one way that this happens is when DNA is copied. Every time that your cells divide, the DNA, all 6 billion base pairs inside that cell, needs to be copied so that each of the two daughter cells will have an entire copy of that DNA. The way that this happens is that your DNA actually splits in half down the middle. And because of the very specific way that the bases match up, enzymes in your cells are able to copy it just by building the other side. So for example, an orange here always matches up with a blue. And enzymes in your cells know that. They're able to put an A with a T. Same thing with the yellow. A cytosine needs a guanine. And so on and so forth. So your enzymes in your cells are incredibly good at doing this. They do it all the time, they do it very rapidly, and they're able to make two DNA molecules out of one. But sometimes, just because of the law of large numbers, they will make mistakes. Even though they're incredibly accurate, with 6 billion base pairs to copy every single time your cells divide, errors are going to happen. It's a little bit difficult to tell what the rate of mutation is or what the rate of error is with those enzymes, but some scientists think that anywhere between 5 and 10 mutations will be instilled into your DNA every single time your cells divide. So now we've made two copies of the same DNA molecule from one. And as you can see, they're exactly identical. On the top you have blue and orange, then orange and blue, green and yellow, blue and orange. So they're exactly the same. So the enzymes in our cell, which in this case is me, were able to copy this DNA exactly. However, sometimes they will make mistakes, and for example, instead of putting a thymine at this position, they might mess up and put in a guanine. If you get a mutation in a linker area of your DNA, for example, it might not be a problem. It might not make you sick. But if this kind of a mutation was in a gene that had something to do with cell growth or cell division, you could wind up with a serious disease such as cancer. So what are other ways that you can get mutations in your DNA? Well, chemicals that cause cancer or that cause DNA mutations like that, or UV light, for example, can actually cause mutations by breaking some of the DNA strands in different places. And things can be replaced that actually shouldn't be. So for example, if a carcinogen, like in cigarette smoke, was able to break this nucleotide out, you know, your cell might try to replace it with, say, a green and a yellow. All of a sudden you have a mutation in a gene that might be very, very important. Another thing that can happen is that you can actually have breakages in the strands of your DNA that can be hard for your cells to repair. So we talked about different mutations that can make you sick, but could it be possible that a mutation could actually make you better? Like in the cartoons, would it be possible that you could have a mutation that would actually make you faster or stronger or give you super senses? Well, you know, it's possible, but it's incredibly, incredibly, incredibly unlikely. Your DNA is such a perfectly tuned system orchestrated over millions of years that the chances that one little change would make things better are incredibly slim. It's far more likely that that one little change would mess up an important function of your body. So probably a mutation isn't actually going to give you super senses, for example. But that doesn't mean that mutations aren't important and that they aren't cool. If our DNA didn't have the ability to occasionally incorporate random mutations, the genetic diversity of life would not exist.